like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot.
Call me Cardi B. I run this shit like cardio.
What's good this week? You can FaceTime with a frozen queen.
My name is Heather Williams. My alter ego is Elsa. I am an esthetician. I'm a teacher. I'm a performer. But I can't do that right now. Everybody's Zooming and FaceTiming.
You're so excited?
And I started to just think to myself, maybe I should do that. And then my friends, they were posting about it, and it just kind of took off.
You know that I could not interview the Elsa without bringing in her biggest fan.
Are you excited to see her?
Hi. Yes, you have a braid. That's beautiful. Oh, you have your hair just like mine. What do alligators do? Yes.
It's time for nap time, right?
No.
Oh, are you going to take this off?
Bye-bye.
Bye, sweetie. I love you.
Love you.
Bye.
Rhett is obsessed with watching all of her videos on Instagram, and if you have a little that would want to follow along with her adventures and her story time, or maybe even FaceTime with Elsa, you too can follow her on Instagram at Priestess Productions. And on that note, be on top, Brittany! Show yourself!
I am here. I have a rod.
You are such a mom of three.
Well,
first of all, that cup is killing me. Are you drinking red?
These are the kids' cups from Disneyland. And I got this beautiful 2014 Gran Vino Tinto in the Mami from Argentina. Mommy Things, I don't know if you heard about this, but they're like a cool subscription box service. And so for Mother's Day, they had sent one of their cool little boxes, and in it was this thing called the cork pop. Have you heard about this?
No.
Right, we're gonna pop it like it's hot. Woo. Press thumb down on top of cartridge while lifting gently. Ooh, are you kidding me? Stop it. Get out of town. You don't understand, my many years of being a server, one of my biggest anxieties was someone would order a bottle of wine.
Sorry.
I'd freak out and I'd run to the back and I'd be like, Eddie, come on. They ordered a bottle of wine. It is the best thing ever.
Wow.
Why didn't I think
of it? No, you're putting your cork pop to practice.
Yeah, so I'm just opening bottles left and right in the house. During this pandemic, we know people are just losing their mind, going out of their mind over The Last Dance, this Michael Jordan documentary. This was the era of the LA Lakers, Magic Johnson, Isaiah Thomas, the Pistons, Scottie Pippen. It was a golden age of basketball. We know that millions of you have been watching this. There's a couple more episodes left. What then? What else is going to help you get through this pandemic? And I think we found the answer. It's right in our backyard.
There's something about how this place forms a different kind of person.
We had the county rocking.
Katie is coming out with a new documentary, Basketball County in the Water. It's about to premiere on Showtime, and it sets out to reveal how where he's from, Prince George's County, Maryland, how in recent years it's been able to produce more basketball stars than any place else on this planet. And we are going to hear from two people that perhaps know this story better than anyone else, Katie's own mama, the real MVP, Mama Durant, and the filmmaker and longtime friend, Jimmy Jenkins.
Basketball can bring you whatever you want from it.
Growing up, basketball, it was life for us. This was where we created our brotherhood. This is where we learned about manhood, just being with our coaches. And, you know, looking at Kevin's story, you know, he wears 35 because of one of his coaches.
As a single mom, I know I look to coaches and the positive men that were around basketball to influence my son, to instill, help me instill some of the qualities and characteristics that I wanted in my son.
The mothers, like, this is something that's very consistent with a lot of these players that made it. A lot of them were single moms. Quinn Cook's mom, single. Victor Oladipo's mom, single. Kevin Durant's mom, you know, single mom. and they were raising these kids, and it was more of, you know, kids will come over each other's houses.
Yes.
The moms was everybody's mom.
That's right. So
that's just how the community works.
Who can we expect to see in this documentary?
You're going to find stuff you don't know.
The county rocking.
You mentioned Prince George's County. People know what it's about.
We've got footage of Kevin that nobody sees.
Kevin worked from age 9 up until he was drafted. He worked diligently, consistently to persevere for his dreams. And so that's one of the messages that I hope that parents pull from this piece, is that it's not an overnight success.
Of course, you're going to see Michael Beasley. You're going to see Nolan Smith, Victor Oladipo, Quinn Cook, Jeff Green, Jared Jack. Adrian Dantley, Walt Williams, Steve Francis, DeMar Johnson. These are all guys. Marissa Coleman, to touch on the women's side.
In the water.
In the water. You're going to see some stories that really shaped our community, preferably the Lynn Bias story. It shaped us as a county. It shaped us. It shaped us in a very, very difficult time. It was the murder capital. It's just so much drugs.
I'm grateful because my sons had to walk past some of these drug-infested areas to get to the rec center. A lot of children were dealing with that, but they had a zero focus into getting to the rec and playing basketball. So it was really, I believe, a God-given tool or resource for our children back then, and even for today.
It was much bigger than just a game. It was an escape for us. It was a love for us. And we depended on the game. And I think that as we grew older, we started to realize this is different. Okay, this is unique. Most counties don't have this. And I just started, as I got older, I'm just like, we got less than 1 million people here. Like, how are we producing all these players?
It wasn't just about we're going to make NBA players. You know, there was a broader scope. And for me, like other parents, it was for their children to get education that I couldn't afford.
I don't think you know what you did. When you didn't eat, you made sure we ate. You went to sleep hungry. You sacrificed for us. You the real MVP.
You think about that moment still?
I'm still tearful of it. Even with all the love and honor that he gave me that day, I was not a perfect mother. And I tell mothers that because sometimes they think they have to be this perfect woman, this bionic woman, so to speak. Well, all you have to do to get a response from your children like that, and most children give that type of accolade to their mother, is to be present and to be engaging. And that's all they want to know, is that you're there with them, that you support them. And sometimes your support is even a no. Extremely proud of him. And I just love watching him play because I think he's the best player in the world, hands down.
So when are we going to play again? Give us the update. I want the inside scoop.
Don't tell anybody. He will be back next year.
I love it.
Like I'm leaning in because I'm whispering, okay?
Kevin Durant has a fantastic part towards it, and it's the one part that gets me teary-eyed. And it's every mother. She's representing every mother of Prince George's County. And what I want to make sure is every father, every mother, every friend, every little brother, every big brother is proud that they're from this county.
To piggyback off that, Jimmy, this is just as rare and special for you. This is once in a lifetime right here.
It's the grace of God for me. It's the grace of God. Everybody that you play with, they all your big brothers. It don't matter who they are. Kevin, KD and Rich Kleiman came on board, and then they supported us. They said, listen, we believe in this story. We were first-time filmmakers. Well, not first time, but at this level, first time. And that's how it came together. And that's what the blessing was. And so for me, I might not have made it to the NBA, but me making it to Showtime at the age of 29, it ain't no difference. I'm reaching my dream. I'm reaching my goal. I'm touching what God has for me. So what makes it even better is when you're able to do that with people you grew up with. On May 15th, I'm gonna be happy for Kevin. I'm gonna be happy for Quinn. I'm gonna be happy for Vic. I'm gonna be happy for Miss Janet Cook. I'm gonna be happy for Miss Wanda Durant. I'm gonna be happy for all of them because it's their work that we're showing.
I can't wait. I'm gonna watch before I watch anything else. I'm still on episode 2 of Game of Thrones, and that was 12.
so much. Thank you for welcoming me into your Zoom room. That's what I call it, Zoom room. So thank you so much. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you, guys.
Stay in touch. Everybody stay safe.
You too. Right. Bless you all. All right. Bye.
Talk soon. Bye. All right. Bye. Shout out to the DMV.
They make you proud.
Oh my God. So proud. So proud. I'm excited for this debut.
I know. It does make you really, really proud. And Basketball County, just so you know, In the Water debuts May 15th on Showtime.
We'll be watching with you for sure on Friday.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of sports, remember that auction item I won where I could train with the MMA ref with eight of my friends?
We still got to show that.
I know, but when are we going to be able to do that? That's my... I don't know. Well, don't worry. If, like me, you can't jump into a cage to kick or punch your way out, don't worry, because you can still watch others do it. And with my bookie, there is never a quarantine on fun. You got that right. Life without sports, we know, slowly drawing to the end. We hear the MLB, they're planning to try to do a July opening. NFL's already released all their schedules for the fall. We don't know what all of this is going to look like, but we know people want to get on with their lives. And we also know that the UFC, they are putting on its first shows in nearly 2 months, okay? Everybody's going to be tuning in for this. And you know, there's going to be every type of bet you can possibly imagine, because everybody's looking for some kind of entertainment. And betting is back with my bookie. Maybe a little blood sport. Maybe it's not your thing. Do not worry. Have fun on the house with a wager you just cannot lose. You simply cannot lose. This Saturday, grab a risk-free bet up to $49 from our friends at MyBookie. Don't forget, you can also try the MyBookie Casino. This is right up Chin's alley, okay? Instant access to hundreds of classic slots, table games. It's just like the real thing. Well, as close as you can get to it at this point. New blackjack tournaments every week where you can enter free, win a big part of the pot, the big jackpot.
Yes, go to mybookie.ag and use promo code OhMyGoff, and they'll match your deposit halfway all the way up to 1,000, a whole stack, okay? So if you put in $100, they'll spot you $50. With MyBookie, you bet, you win, and most importantly, when you win, you secure that bag.
Cha-ching!
Remember my...
What? Oh my God! That looks so Mona freaky. Lisa, Mona Lisa, men have named you.
You're so like the lady with the mystic smile. Is it only cause you're lonely that blamed you?
Enough with the theatrics. To be quite candid, I just wanted to be picture perfect to introduce this next segment. Think about, what are you going to get when you have a bunch of creatives stuck at home in the middle of the pandemic? What do you do?
Julie Mudrick from Vienna, Virginia. I'm a stay-at-home mom of five, and I love creating. For 7 years now, I've dressed up for the bus for my kids, so I have all of these costumes. And so now that I have my kids home, I've decided, after I read about the Rijksmuseum Museum in the Netherlands, they challenge people to recreate famous works of art and post it on Instagram while we're in quarantine. We're used to this sort of thing, and I'm going to use it as a way to teach my children. So I wanted them to get into art a little more and just learn some of the classics. So we have begun dressing up as different art. I love that they're learning at the same time.
What masterpieces have you finished?
So some of my favorites that we've done is The Son of Man by Marguerite. Another one was Ophelia, where my daughter got in the bathtub and I taught them about Shakespeare's Hamlet and what happened with Ophelia.
You're in your clothes.
It was like floating because it was a dress.
Then I love doing the swing. It is in Frozen. So, mm-hmm. Of course, my kids loved that.
Set, go.
So you have quite the supporting cast.
I do. The Nightmare is another one, and it's a woman lying on a bed and someone sitting on her chest, just this weird looking creature, and then a horse head.
Because of course you have a horse head just laying around.
I totally have a horse head. Who doesn't have a horse head?
I have a horse head. And and anyone who knows me is
that's why I like you.
Do you have a wish list, so to speak?
As Nighthawk, if you've ever seen it, it's a couple in a cafe and with people, and it's kind of outside looking in. And I feel like the world is all in right now.
What has been the best part?
Realizing how easy it is to make something cool and fun out of what you already have at home.
How has it been working on something fun, but then also learning the history behind it?
Get both sides of it so you can have fun while getting educated while doing it.
It's more hands-on, so it's not like you're sitting in an online class, but you're getting to kind of experience something for yourself.
I just hope that people are able to enjoy this time with their families. I know it's hard, and I can't say that it's always like roses here, but I hope that with a little creativity that they can really make the best out of the situation.
So a big thank you to Julie and her entire fantastic family. That was so much fun, and look forward to following all of their creations and adventures. Next week, we've got a fun show planned for you. We check in with Miss America, the new Miss America, and we find out how someone whose main job is to travel around and to see people on a daily basis, multiple people during a day, how is she getting by during this pandemic? And also how she's teaming up with someone here locally who really is making the best of her time at home in the kitchen, blending two of her favorite things, food and science.
Yes, and don't forget to send us your videos, show us how you're quarantining at home, info@ohmygoff.com, and binge on all of our episodes. This is the time to be doing it. Comment, share, like, subscribe. All you gotta do is go to ohmygoff.com to catch up on all of our latest episodes.
Thank you everybody for joining us. Love you, Brittany. Hope to see you soon.
Love you.
Take it away, Dolly. Want to say hi to Brittany?
Hi, Brittany.
Good
night. I love you.
Love you.
Sweet dreams.
Bye, Ren.
Okay, bye.